Oren lifts a finger to his lips, still tensed, in the direction of the far wall. Another clatter now, a definite sound of movement rather than the susurration of rising water. Johnny starts to pant, his airways constricting all over again as his prospects narrow down to either a charging battalion of heavily armed terrorists or a remorseless wall of seawater, until he sees the face on the shape emerging from the gloom. Chapter 33, Wednesday, 8 p.m. By now the dark is so intense, it has an almost physical quality. Lola can see nothing other than the occasional shimmer of moonshine off the sea. They're moving away from the banana plants now, ankle deep in water, following the smooth line of the cliff. Every soft splash reminds Lola that in a matter of moments, the water could be over her head, and all she's got as an anchor is sand beneath her feet. Ahead, the stranger turns, somehow into the cliff, into an opening that Lola can't see, only sense, as the dark swallows them up almost immediately. "Careful here," the stranger murmurs, his voice echoing awkwardly back at her. "It can be really slippery in places." Lola plants her feet as deliberately as her body will let her. The ground is sloping steeply upward with every step. They're out of the water in a matter of seconds, but Lola knows this tide. It rises high and fast. In a freak storm, it would be impossible to outrun, even if the gradient to this slope was almost vertical. She cocks her head, straining for the ocean's song, still whispering. No freak storm whipping overhead.